The show must go on. How the Los Angeles Chamber Orchestra is putting on concerts this summer in the midst of the coronavirus pandemic. That conversation after this break. Mozart's Clarinet Quintet, performed last weekend by the Los Angeles Chamber Orchestra. Yep, this is most certainly not your typical classical music concert, but hey, it's something. I caught up recently with the orchestra's executive director, Ben Cadwallader, who happened to take on this job back on March 9th. The orchestra's offices closed just a week later.
Yeah, that's right. It was a trial by fire, to say the very least. I started at the beginning of March, and then things shut down, obviously, after just about a week in the office. On one hand, you know, that's a almost unsurmountable challenge, something that you can barely even wrap your head around. But on the other hand, the way that I've been looking at it, I'm an optimist, and so in my view, if there is any point during a leader's tenure to tackle a challenge like this, I would argue that the beginning is probably the best time. I'm not coming in, I have some ideas, I'm familiar with the organization, but I'm not coming in with a fully fledged vision. I'm not coming in with an absolute clear path and answers. I'm coming in with questions and an open mind, and that is, I think, exactly what that alchemy is exactly what you need to tackle a challenge like this. And on the staff side too, on the board side, on the musician side, likewise, they're coming, looking at me with questions and trying to figure out, you know, who is this guy? What kind of priorities does he have? And so I think altogether it makes for a great mix for us to tackle this challenge with optimism, creativity, innovation, all of the kind of hallmarks of what make LACO great.
Yeah. And at some point you decide, okay, the show must go on. So tell me how you have been having these performances. Paint the picture for us.
Yeah, so the show must go on. That's exactly right. We came to the realization that if the show must go on, if we're not just going to go dark, we have to move onto the digital space, or concerts simply are not going to happen. Musicians are not going to go back to work. We're not going to be able to get to serve our mission, to connect people through music. And so once we came to that realization, we acknowledged that we have to basically become a different organization. LACO orchestras are very analog organizations historically. In realizing that, we knew we had to do essentially some research and development. And R&D is not something that's natural to orchestras. And so that is where the summer festival came into play. We had a generous donor who basically provided seed funding for the first two performances of what is now a summer series, the first time LACO has ever done a summer series. And it may seem counterintuitive to, during a time like this, to launch a brand new product line, essentially. But in fact, it is, in our view, necessary in order for us to build the internal competencies that are required so that we can hit the ground running in the fall with concerts that hopefully are larger in scale, scope, and impact. So that was where Summer Series came from.
So tell me what it looks like, these performances that you've done. What are you doing to keep the musicians safe? How does this work from the audience vantage point?
Yeah, so the concerts are entirely digital. You can only access them through streaming platforms, of course. But what we're doing to keep musicians safe, the LA County has released a set of guidelines for major studios to go back to work. So as funny as it may seem, humble LACO is actually in the same category as the big, you know, Paramount, Disney, and all these major studios. So we overlay our own safety guidelines on those county guidelines for studios. And it's things like, obviously, social distancing and masks, but like wind and brass players who need their mouths, who can't play their instruments with a mask, they have to be put in these kind of plexiglass boxes. You'll see this on the broadcast from this past weekend. And there are a lot of other backstage, you know, HVAC circulation requirements that are needed that we can accommodate. And from an audience standpoint, again, it's streamed online. The concerts are short, shorter than a typical concert, 30, 40 minutes. And they're intimate. They're up close and personal in a way that I've had longtime subscribers, people who for decades have been coming to LACO concerts, experiencing live music, have said, I've never had an experience like this where you feel like you're in the living room, you're on stage with the artist. You're actually getting something unique, something you wouldn't get in the concert hall through these performances over the summer. That's our fervent hope over the summer. And again, as we go into the fall, that's really important that what we offer is digitally native. It is unique. It is not just another recorded concert. It feels special in a really crowded digital landscape.
And talk to me about the musical selections that you've chosen for these performances. How are they, you know, how do you make those choices? Are they responding in any way, shape, or form to the times we now find ourselves living in?
To a certain extent. So the real stars of LACO are the musicians, the performers. And they're all, you know, you and all of your viewers have heard LACO musicians perform on every movie, every TV show. So they're really the stars of LACO. And so each of these concerts, we have a musician who's kind of the leader, the coordinator, who comes up with the repertoire. So the extent to which it's a response to these times, I guess I would say one of the ways in which our organization is pivoting is to do a better job of highlighting voices of color, composers of color, artists of color, who historically have been marginalized in classical music due to the systemic racism that we're all kind of grappling with and understanding. So that's one of the ways you will see throughout the summer series and into the fall. This is not a short change. This is an organizational change. You will see more voices of color, composers of color, artists of color, musicians of color on our stages and on our programs. But these programs are designed to be, it's still serious, it's still classical music, but it's lighter. It's kind of summer fare, that kind of you want to sit out on a picnic and have a glass of wine kind of music. So it's an exciting shift for LACO, for sure.
I was just going to say, it sounds like the musical equivalent of a rosé, right? Something lighter for summer, right? So I'm wondering if you could talk to me, because when I picture a chamber orchestra, I picture, you know, I picture an orchestra that is more intimate in nature. And usually, you know, traditionally, musicians in such a situation would sit closer to each other. And it doesn't, you know, which isn't to say you can't do this from a social distance. But I'm curious, what if the musician said to you about what it's like performing in this new way?
Yeah, it's really fascinating to get the musician standpoint on this, because there are very tangible technical issues with acoustics. When you have players literally in boxes 14 feet away from each other, one of our violinists made the point to me that at the recording from this past weekend, he was nearly 30 feet away from the cellist on the other side of the stage. So there are acoustical challenges there. There are also communication challenges. Part of chamber music, as you just pointed out, is making adjustments, instantaneous adjustments in real time, and communicating with things like breath and body language and eyes. And that's really hard to do when you have somebody who's 30 feet across the stage. So in the same way that, you know, your senses are heightened when you lose one of your senses, the other senses are heightened. What we're finding is that eye contact is elevated in importance when your mouth, most of your face is covered. And to address the acoustical challenges, this goes back to the R&D aspect of this. We may be experimenting with earpieces where you have one earbud in that feeds into the audio booth, so you can hear the actual mix in real time, because you can't necessarily 100% rely on the live acoustics in the room. So that's still something where we are figuring out, and a new competency also that musicians are having to build. They're all used to performing in studios with headphones on, but this is different. This is a hybrid reliance on real-time acoustics and also the mix from the audio booth. So we're still very much figuring that out. It's a totally different experience for all of us.
Yeah, those musicians, they've got to get their smize on, right? I got to say, Ben, I was thinking about you. As luck would have it, just this morning, I went out on a run, and it just so happens that there were a troupe of mariachis that were playing in front of someone's house, and it absolutely stopped me in my tracks. And even thinking about it now, I get a little bit choked up because I realized I hadn't heard live music in months now. And hearing it again after so long, it was like a glass of fresh cold water, you know, in the middle of the desert. As tough as everything is right now, do you feel like when the worst of this is behind us and people are able to go and experience the LA Chamber Orchestra again, do you think, will absence have made the heart grow fonder, I guess is the bottom line?
There really is no substitution for that in-person experience. And I think in times like this, we think sometimes of beauty and art as nice things to have, maybe a nice distraction from the daily horror of 2020. But I think it's more profound than that too, as you touched on with your run this morning, that it is a reminder, a potent reminder of why this is so difficult, of why this is so painful, of what we're fighting for, of what we as a species are capable of when we do things together. And that is, you know, access to beauty, whether it's a mariachi band or a chamber orchestra, is a fundamental human right. And when this pandemic lifts, whenever that happens, we will be here, we'll be making music for you, for our audiences, and we can't wait to see everyone. And in the meantime, we'll be on your computer screens, on your phones, and on your computers. It's a healthy reminder. I love that story with the mariachi band.
I'll send you the video. Ben Cadwallader of the LA Chamber Orchestra, thank you so much for making the time during this digital intermission.
Thank you, Alex. It was a pleasure.